What up, guys? It's your boy Gus from Gus Villa Jewelry, back with another video in kind of a somber mood in a way. I figured I'd make this video because somehow I've been sucked into this whole drama that the YouTube space is going through right now, more specifically of the watch world, because I do buy and sell watches. You guys have seen them on my story. I talk about them on my YouTube channel. So I've been kind of asked over and over and over through DMs and comments on YouTube channel what my opinion of is. And if you guys haven't heard, it's about the Anthony Ferrar, which is the timepiece gentleman, and his recent admitting to have stolen $5 million worth of investor money and client money. And so, I didn't want to do this video, to be honest with you, because I like to keep things really lighthearted. But I've been asked so many times that I figured I'd just let you guys know about it and kind of in a dark way to almost not only, defend, I don't know why our credibility or my credibility has even been in question because of this, but I guess it's just a really easy time for everybody to throw rocks and stones to the people who sell jewelry and watches, etc. So I wanted to kind of give my opinion about it and let you guys know how I feel about it, number one. But number two, and more importantly, to kind of teach a lesson that I think is very, very important either way, because it's something that I preach and I've been preaching since day one. And that ultimately is trust in your person that you are going to buy something from. So if you haven't heard about it, there's a really big YouTube channel called The Timepiece Gentleman. He used to have a partner before. I've been actually watching their videos for quite some time. He had a partner. He split up. He started doing his own thing. The guy named by the Anthony Ferrar. If you guys have seen the admission video, cool. If not, you guys, I'm sure, can YouTube it. But the guy would do consignment. Consignment is when someone sells or sends you their watch for you to sell for them. They take a commission and they give you the rest of the money. It's kind of like Chrono 24, the big ones. And he also buys and sells watches, et cetera. And for the past 2 to 3 years, basically, he's been on his own and he stole a bunch of money. And eventually, kind of when the Ponzi scheme runs out, he kind of got caught and he just released a long confessional, saying sorry to the people who he had defrauded and a bunch of other stuff there. And I just saw the video 2 days ago when it came out because people were sending it to me and it was just all the buzz. And I sat through the whole thing and just kind of looked at it. And my initial thoughts were obviously just like everybody else, right? So like I would say I'm a person who does buy and sell watches. I'm a big fan of watches. I have a watch on 99% of the time. And I'm also a person who buys and sells jewelry, diamond jewelry, regular jewelry. I fabricate it and I sell it. And these are high ticket items that number one, of course, just like any other watch dealer in the world and any other jeweler in the world, is built on trust, right? That is the basis of our industry. And I think, and I've been saying this for a really long time, that our industry specifically is one that gets cast a shadow of being shady, of being ugly, of lying to people, of misleading people, of telling a lot of information out there that's just not correct. And when, of course, I saw this video for the first time, I initially thought, oh, here we go, everybody who ever hates on jewelry or hates on people who are in the gray market who buy and sell Rolexes and watches in general, this is their excuse to go out and start talking trash. But in this particular case, it is 100% justified because I was that guy too. I was that guy who was saying, bro, how can you do that? And to be honest with you, it's the first initial feeling was just anger. Why would you do that to so many people? I put myself in his shoes who manage people who I buy and sell jewelry to from and who I buy Rolexes and I sell them, watches, etc. The number one thing that I have to control, the number one thing is the trust of people. When someone is buying a chain from me or when someone is buying anything from me, they are buying it basically because they see my social media account. That's the first thing. That's my number one way of marketing to them. It's not going around and handing out flyers to people in Miami. It's through social media marketing, more specifically YouTube and Instagram and Facebook. And so the first sight that they see of me, I have to somehow build that trust. And when someone comes and calls me on the phone and tells me, hey, I want to buy a $50,000 bust down chain. I want to buy a $10,000 chain. I want to buy that Rolex that I saw in your story. I want to buy whatever. It is an insane responsibility as a person number one as a business owner, but number one, or sorry, as a business owner, number one, to do what the hell is right, because that person is trusting in what you are doing and what you are saying, and that everything that they are about to buy is exactly what they are going to get. And I think that as a business owner, it's an extremely frustrating situation for people who actually do this honestly, right? So people who actually care about what other customers do. And I'm not trying to be this martyr like, oh, look at me, I'm the good guy, he's the bad guy. But damn it if I don't try at least very, very hard to be as transparent as possible. And if you know me in my personal life, or if you've been following this channel for a while, or my Instagram more specifically, you know that before I used to go lives, and I love transparency because it keeps you informed and it keeps me letting you know that everything that you're buying is exactly what you're getting. So as an initial reaction when I saw it as a business owner, I was very, very frustrated with the situation because I knew that it was going to have backlash on people who are actually doing things right. My second reaction was genuine disappointment for the people who have gotten ultimately screwed by this dude. And I don't know the dude. I've never done business with the guy. I've never seen the guy in my life, right? But like him, I know many people in this industry, unfortunately, and many people who say things and then do the complete opposite. And I think that for the reasons that hurt the most out of all this is for the people who trusted him. You know, I have had so many times people come up to me and say that, hey, listen, you know, I'm in a tight bind. I'm in a tight situation. Can I sell you my chain? Or can I sell you this particular watch or whatever it is, things that I buy on a constant basis. And I see the necessity in their hand, and sometimes they don't know the true value of their pieces that they're selling me, et cetera, et cetera. And to take advantage of someone who has consigned a piece to you, consignment is the ultimate sign of trust to a watch dealer. That means I have this Rolex on or I have this watch on, I send it to you. God knows what kind of situation I'm in. I am trusting that you are going to do by your part and say what you're going to do and sell that piece for me and give me my commission for that, number one, that price point, and number two, that I'm going to not have you send and steal that money from me. Because ultimately, I have, you know, my ball is in your court, so to speak. Like, there's nothing I could do if you do this to me. And for the thousands and thousands of people that he conned because of that, it's an extremely frustrating situation. I was just having a conversation with my boy Creep, who wants to be a pilot. And, you know, I told him, I was like, what if you had a bunch of Rolexes or something of value, right? And you went out to this guy and you said, hey, man, sell me this piece. And I go and I turn around and I sell those pieces. And with that money, I go and I party it to fund the lifestyle that I don't have and try to put on this front. And at the end of the day, I'm spending your hard-earned money. Now, if I spend that money, what do you do as a consumer, right? It's something that can put a lot of people in a really, really terrible situation. So the responsibility as a business owner who's reselling someone else's product, or that is ultimately taking in someone's hard-earned money. I say that all the time. I understand that jewelry is not a necessity. It's not bread that you're putting on someone's table for your kids. It is 100% a luxury. However, people still work very, very hard for it. I get it all the time. Hey, man, I'm saving up for a chain. I'm going to hit you up in a couple of months. And then a couple of months come by and I get them in my DMs and I'll see the conversation dated August of 2022. And now I see it July of 2023. Hey, man, I just came up with the money. Do you know what 11 months of saving up is like? That's a really, really huge deal. And that's a lot of hard-earned money. And for you to throw it away on someone just because you want to fund someone's lifestyle is ridiculous. And it's a very, very terrible thing to do as a human. Forget just as a business owner, as a human. And not to mention his employees and all this other stuff. Now, I don't want to sit there and throw the complete house at him and shade at him, even though he solely deserves it. You know, I feel bad for him. It doesn't seem like what he's doing is genuine. He's had this, you know, this track to success that he's going to pay everybody back. And sincerely, for the people who he conned, I really sincerely do hope he does. But the bigger lesson in all of this, and this is really why I want to drive it home, and I don't want to ramble about the same stuff that everybody else is going to talk about. But more specifically, I want to leave you guys with this one point and one point only. There is a saying that you guys have heard me say. If you've spoken to me on the telephone, I always say it. And I leave you with the story that just happened to me less than 48 hours ago. If you are the person who this happened and who you know who you are, if you watch my YouTube channel, I'm not going to put your name out there. I just want to show you an example. Someone called me quite literally this morning, and it's ironic, and this is the reason that tipped the straw that broke the camel's back to make this video. Someone called me this morning and asked me that they had were in a tight jam, and they had gone to a couple of pawn stores. And those pawn stores had told them that the carrot that was promised in the chain that I sold them wasn't the correct carrot. And I woke up because this, I guess they text me early. I opened up my phone, and this is the first message I saw in the DM. And I immediately answered back to them. I said, hey, man, that is impossible. Because the exact carrot, if you purchased 18 carat, you have gotten 18 carat without a shadow of a doubt. I slept well knowing that that was correct. But he had gone to these three pawn stores, and they had all told him that it was incorrect. I asked him, I probed him, what did these pawn stores do? Did anyone hit it with an XRF gun, which is the true way to measure a carrot, right? Ultimately, after getting doing the whole run around, he told me the situation. I realized very quickly that these pawn stores were not testing this correctly. One had even done a scratch test. It had passed it. But because they don't regularly see Cuban chains in 18 karat, they couldn't trust that the scratch test was correct. They went to another person. That person looked at it and said, hey, this doesn't look 18 karat, as if that were the tall tale sign. But the point is, my credibility was questioned. And I'm completely understanding of that. I wasn't super negative. And that person, if you want to comment in down below and you can understand, I spoke to that person right on the phone. I called them via Instagram and I had a conversation with them. I understood his questioning my credibility. I get it. Even though I was very, very thorough in the beginning, I still do it because I understand. I have something that I constantly, constantly repeat. And it means trust but verify. I got it off the movie. There's a series called Chernobyl, and there's a part where the main character is being followed by the KGB, and the guy turns around, the leader of the KGB turns around and says, hey man, I trust you, but we verify. It's an old KGB saying, and I stuck with me forever. You have to trust but verify. Eventually, I referred him over to another pawn store who did have an XRF gun. He was able to pawn the piece, et cetera, et cetera. They hit it with it. Of course, I hit 18 karat. But the point I'm trying to make in all this, the whole Anthony Farrar situation, the whole misusing of $5 million, which is what his debt is, the main lesson to learn here is you have to trust the person that you're going to be doing business with. Now, how do you do that? Ask for referrals. Ask other people who are in the industry as well. Hey, have you heard about this person? Do your homework. Just because someone has a YouTube channel with a million followers, even myself, whatever the hell I say, trust it, but verify it. That is the way you do business. And at the end of the day, the most important part about it is you have to take into consideration everything anybody says to you, but always go back and verify that information. Your reputation as a business is the most important thing that you do. When I sell you a diamond, it's the exact same diamond. And if I don't, you can come back to me and I have to respond for it. It's not just saying it. That's what brings businesses down, the lack of trust, the lack of you saying that you're going to do something and then you do the complete opposite. So in any business that you do, it doesn't matter if you have a million followers on Twitter. It doesn't matter if you seem like the coolest person. It doesn't matter if you sit back and watch all my videos and you think that Gus can't possibly lie. I don't care. Trust me, but verify me. And that's all I got to say. I hope this was informative. I hope this doesn't stop you from going out there and buying watches in the gray market, because those are a very small percentage of what a lot of us spend so much time trying to do, which is just do the right thing. Do business the right way, and it's going to the ones that don't do it the right way are usually never in there for the long run. The ones that do it the right way, we're the ones that stick around, and hopefully I'll be the one that stick around for a very long time. I appreciate you guys as always. I'm sorry for the somber mood. I really am, but I just wanted to give you guys my 2 cents because I've been asked a million times. So here it is as always, okay? Love you guys, and I'll catch you guys in another video. Hopefully it's a lot lighter mood. See you guys later.